Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's your girl Fanny&jessy back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. Like I said, my name is Fanny&jessy and on this channel we post reaction videos each and every day. So if there is something in particular that you guys want us to do, drop us a link in the comment section below and we'll do it for you. You can check out our second YouTube channel called Fanny&jessy 2.0. Head there, subscribe, and enjoy our weekly content. We've got a podcast called Diving In with Fanny&jessy, and we've got some amazing conversations which you guys can find on iTunes, Spotify, Podbean, this channel, or our second YouTube channel for the visual. And we've got a Patreon. You guys can feel free to become members and we'll appreciate. A big shout out to everyone that has subscribed to our channel so far. Thank you for subscribing, liking, commenting, sharing, and everything that you guys are doing. We're very, very grateful. So I hope you guys are doing all right and may you stay blessed. So today I'm going to be reacting to what one of you suggested. So today we're going to be reacting to a miraculous prophecy by Prophet Muhammad on modern banking system. Without wasting time, let's get into the video.
And our Prophet, Allah's blessings be upon him, has warned about riba. He said, the time will come when you'll not be able to find a single person in all of mankind who will not be consuming riba. And whoever says he's not consuming riba, verily the dust of riba would be upon him. Verily the vapor of riba would reach him. So there is no escape. None.
Meaning this is the mother of all attacks that will ever be launched on mankind. Because it's not just Muslims, it's all of mankind. This is the mother of all attacks that will be launched on all of mankind, this one. So what is riba? When we go to the Quran, Allah speaks about riba in that last revelation. And it is a loan of money in which the lender has to be repaid with more than what he lent. So he's using money to make money. And so there you are. Riba is the money lender, lending money on interest. Yesterday he was condemned for it. But today he has a black suit and a tie. Right? With a tie. And he's very respectably known as the banker. No, you're not a banker, you're a money lender. Why has Allah prohibited riba, money being lent on it? They don't teach this in universities, no. I've studied in several universities, I know. In Surah Ar-Rum of the Quran, Allah begins the process of teaching the subject. And He does it by offering a contrast between riba and charity. وَمَا آتَيْتُمْ بَعَدَوْزُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَمَا آتَيْتُمْ مِنْ رِبًا لِيَرْبُوَ فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ فَلَا يَرْبُوَ عِنَّ اللَّهِ. That which you put out or you invest in riba, that your capital sum might increase at the expense of the wealth of others. فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ. It will not increase with Allah. Allah rejects this. وَمَا آتَيْتُ مِنْ زَكَاةٍ تُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَ اللَّهِ. But what you give in charity, seeking Allah's face, Allah's pleasure. فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُضْعِفُونَ. This is going to multiply many, many, many times. And so you have to ask the question, because the Quran does not tell you, and the Hadith does not tell you, and so you have to think. Why has Allah offered the contrast between riba and charity? It took me 4 months in New York in the early 90s to try to answer that question. It took me 4 months driving all over New York and New Jersey and Connecticut, lecturing all over the place, facing the traffic in the Long Island Expressway. So one day the answer came to me in a flash. That's how it usually happens. Provided you have made the effort. وَأَلَيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى. And you will not get anything other than that for which you have made an effort. What is a perfect act of charity? It is to give and to take nothing in return. What is a perfect act of riba? It is to take and give nothing in return. When once we understand that, we will know it's going to be the mother of all betrayals. Allah is teaching you in the Quran that the perfect act of charity is one in which you give and you take nothing in return. And the perfect act of riba is the opposite. It is that in which you take and you give nothing in return. And so eventually Africa becomes poor, and Pakistan becomes poor, and Bangladesh becomes poor, and Indonesia becomes poor, and Egypt becomes poor, and Algeria becomes poor, and Morocco becomes poor. Shall I continue? It's happening in our watch. And when they become poor, it doesn't stop there. Because Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam spoke. But who cares about the Prophet today? Who cares about him? That even if riba is a little bit, he said, it will still end in poverty and destitution. Those were his words. It's just a matter of time. And why are they doing this? Why are they reducing all of mankind to poverty and destitution? And people have to run from Pakistan. Who wants to live in Pakistan? And they have to come where the money is. If you want to live a good life, instead of asking the question, why is Pakistan poor? And what can I do to stop the rot? No. Allah speaks in the Quran a second time to explain why riba is haram. It's there in the Quran and you read it. And he says, الَّذِينَ يَأْكُلُونَ الرِّبَى. Those who consume riba, لَا يَكُومُونَ إِلَّا كَمَا يَكُومُ الَّذِي يَتَخَبَّتُهُ الشَّيْطَانُ مِنَ الْمَسْ. They do not live except as a people who appear to be driven to madness by the touch of shaitan. From the oval, the White House, come down, eh? They appear to be a people who have been driven to madness by the touch of shaitan. From the White House, come down. And this is because they say, إِنَّمَا الْبَيْعُ مِثْلُ الرِّبَى. They argue that money lending is a form of business. It's a legitimate form of business to lend money on interest. That's what the universities teach. But Allah responds, and this is His response, وَأَحَلَّ اللَّهُ الْبَيْعَ وَحَرَّمَ الرِّبَى. But Allah has made business halal and He's made riba haram. This is what Allah says. He has made business halal and He's made riba haram. So what is the message? Over there the contrast was charity and riba. Over here the contrast is business and riba. But the verse does not tell you why it is not business. In a business transaction, you have to embrace risk, R-I-S-K. You can make a profit or you can suffer a loss. The best businessman will tell you that. Sometimes you can make a profit and sometimes you can suffer a loss. That is business. And when you embrace risk, you take the chance. Then Allah says that it is His responsibility, not the Soviet Union, not the socialist economy of Venezuela, of Hugo Chavez, or Fidel Castro. It is His responsibility to distribute wealth and to redistribute wealth. One day for you and one day for him. It is His responsibility to ensure, listen carefully, that wealth does not remain concentrated only with the wealthy. كَيْ لَا يَكُونَ الدُّولَةَ بَيْنَ الْأَغْنِيَاءِ مِنْكُمْ It's in the Quran. No, that's a sick economy where wealth remains permanently with the rich countries of the world. A healthy economy, but they will never teach that in Oxford. A healthy economy is one in which wealth circulates through the economy. So the rich today can be poor tomorrow, and the poor today can be rich tomorrow. And therefore, Allah wants you to embrace risk so that He can intervene to take from some and give to others. That's business. That's the importance of business. So what is riba? In a riba transaction, the moneylender does not want to embrace risk, does not want to suffer loss. He wants a risk-free investment. He wants to immunize himself from the possibility of loss. And when he lends on interest and he secures his capital sum with a mortgage, then provided that the law is on his side, and he can go to the law if the borrower defaults, then the money lender is lending with no possibility of loss, only profit. And because Allah will not intervene now, because you've closed the door on him, the implication of an economy being based on riba, as the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, which says La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, the economy would be one in which the rich of Pakistan would remain permanently rich, and the poor of Pakistan will remain permanently poor. When the rich are permanently rich and the poor are imprisoned in permanent poverty, that is oppression. And so, this is business and this is riba. And riba does not qualify as business. And if you want to know what they do when the banks lend money, it's not just fractional reserve banking. That if I have £100, I can only lend you £100. That's as much as I can lend. But if the bank has 100, they could lend 1,000. Which is sinful. Which is bogus. Which is a ripoff. But it's worse than that. If you read John Perkins, take a note of the book, Confessions of an Economic Hitman, Confessions of an Economic Hitman, you will realize that they lend you money, Pakistan, they make sure that they lend you as much that you cannot repay. That's why they're lending you. So they're using money, loans, in order to trap you and enslave you. That's why they lend you money. It's not just the banking system, which today has trapped and imprisoned so many parts of the world. It's more than that.
Loved this video. Like he said, it's a trap at the end of the day because we're being given something that we can't return. In the end, for example, in the end they end up selling. It's like you're selling your own country. Why in debt? But they keep on giving us money. They know we can't repay. What's the big deal? I mean, like, what's meaning behind all that? Doesn't make sense. And people, governments keep on borrowing, which just doesn't make sense. Another thing is, even though we're borrowing, where is that money going? Because the rich continue getting rich, and the poor are even poorer each minute as we speak. And it's just, and I don't understand how certain money in the world means a lot. Today, if the US dollar goes up or loses its value, the rest of the world is affected. For what reason? Why are we so attached to these Western currencies, Western people, Western ideas? Why are we so dependent on the value of a certain thing that doesn't concern us? Doesn't make sense. Otherwise, I love the Quran and what it stands for. It's like a life, to me, it's like a life lesson. It's giving you what to expect, and it's really up to you to either take into consideration what you're reading and work it out, or just ignore everything. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video, because my battery is low. You.